The first things that we need, of course, we need to have our cotton spool, which is our thread. And what we do here is we lift up this little lever and we slide the spool on like so. Then we have the spool cap. If we just pop this on at the end, this will hold it in place so that it doesn't come pinging out when the thread is being pulled. Now, with this particular machine, we have two different sections that we go around when we are threading it. So we bring our cotton thread around underneath this guide and then through here. Now, what I like to do at this stage is I actually put my finger onto the thread so that I can pull the thread through here so it's nice and tight. What you can do as well, if you want to give it a little bit more tension as well, to make sure it's a nice tightly wound bobbin, is you can go around it twice. You don't have to do this, but I find that it does help. Then what we need to do is we get our bobbin. Now the bobbin has some little holes in the surface, as you can see. So what we need to do is we get the end of our thread and we bring it from the inside out of the bobbin. Oops, let's just pop it through there. Very good. Okay, so it's now going through, as you can see here. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put it onto the bobbin winder. And very important, I need to remember to click it across. And the reason why we do that is because it turns off other parts of the machine. So it's all about health and safety, and also you're not wasting any time. At this point, I can turn the machine on. I'm going to keep hold of this thread up here. I'm going to turn the machine on. And then I'm going to place my foot onto the pedal and it will start to wind the bobbin. Once it is wound a little bit like that, I can get my scissors and I can just snip off the excess. So the little bit that was coming up at the side of the bobbin is now gone. I can put my foot down and let it wind as fast as I feel. So I can do this nice and slowly, or I can do it fast. It all depends about how much pressure you're putting onto the foot pedal. Now, if you really want it to be very, very tight as well, although I've gone around this twice, so I shouldn't need to do this, you can hold onto the thread as it goes through, but I find that actually it's not necessary as long as you have put it around the bobbin winder twice. There we go. Just gonna give it a little bit more. Okay, I'm going to stop it there. When it is done, it tends to stop itself. On this occasion, I don't need a fully wound bobbin, so I'm just going to take this off. First of all, actually, I'm going to turn the machine off. I bring this across and I pull it back up. Now, all I need to do is snip, and I have a beautifully wound bobbin.